Brava Eva, molto bene con il netto al...
A new video. So in this video you are going to get to know Alfie better, and I'm going to do a try on haul for what I got for Valentine's Day. And me and my father are going to buy fake Gucci in Gran Canaria. I actually had finished this video and somehow I have like erased all the content, so now I just have to like film that again. But I don't have actually all the content from Gran Canaria anymore, but I'm just like gonna show you. And yeah, because my plan was like to buy some fake Gucci at Gran Canaria and then do one of those videos that you go with fake Gucci to the Gucci store in another video when all this quarantine is over. So let's see how it goes. Okay guys, now I'm ready to go out and ride with Alfie. So this is the first time for Alfie to ride on this new place. I think it's really funny because every time on Instagram when I do like a poll where you guys can choose the horse that you want, a lot of people choose Alfie. And I sort of get that because when you see the videos when I jump with him, he looks like so uncomplicated and so like easy to ride. But he's really difficult to ride because he's very, very spooky. He's extremely sensitive. He does not allow the rider to make one mistake because he's really careful at the jumps. He's also very brave, but he really needs to trust the rider. And just like a thing, if something goes wrong in his morning routine, that can make his whole day be horrible. That can make him not want to go when he comes in the ring. It's not that he wants to stop, it's just that he's so stressed because everything didn't go exactly to how he is expecting it to be, how it is every day. So just a little change in what we normally do is like a huge thing for him. Like you see now, he's already behaving crazy because he's like, oh my god, this is not normal. So anyway, let's go out to ride.
Dismont serait les bienvenus pour lui souhaiter bonne chance. Allez, la Norvégienne, enfin l'épreuve.
Norway takes their turn with Eva Irene Usan aboard the gelding. He's by Arpeggio. This is Alf Buddy.
Que je vous demanderai, c'est un tonnerre d'applaudissements pour Eva Irene Usan qui doit être bien déçue elle aussi de ne pouvoir poursuivre la compétition pour la deuxième désobéissance. Et très bien ce qu'elle vient de faire, important pour le moral du cheval, lui montrer qu'il n'avait aucune raison de s'arrêter. Et ils sont bien vos applaudissements pour l'accompagner. Bon, eh bien non.
So in the clip that you just saw where Alfie didn't want to jump, his morning hadn't gone as planned because something had happened. So the person who was supposed to feed him in the morning had overslept and he didn't get his breakfast. So when I came at 7:30, he still hadn't gotten his food and there were no time for us to morning ride before the arena closed. This was really, you know, not according to the schedule how he really used to have it at shows, because he always gets food early, then he goes to morning ride and then he is positive and relaxed to jump later. So he hadn't had the possibility to go to morning ride because the Longines Masters of Lausanne was a very special show that you couldn't just ride when you wanted. You had to ride in the riding times because they didn't have so much space. So the result was that he couldn't come out at all
only for a little bit of hand walking in the morning. And that is something that is strange for him because that's not how he's used to. And then he's too tense afterwards and then he's afraid to go. Like you can also see here at the new stable, he's really scared. He doesn't want to leave the stable. He wants to stay with his friends. But what is really important is that I just stay calm, that I don't get angry or try to hit him or anything. I have to just stay calm and slowly, slowly convince him to go. Because Alfie is a very special horse. He's a very talented horse and very, very sensitive horse. So if you, with a horse like this, start to hit him or be brutal with him, he will never trust you and you can end up, worst case scenario, to have a horse that just stands on two legs in the corners all the time. So all horses are different and every horse have to be treated according to their personality. If, for example, Duke or Pixie or Princey was behaving like this, I would give them a little hard kick with the leg and give them a slam slam with the whip and say, no more joking, now you listen, you go, you're brave. And then the discussion would be finished, they would give up and go. But Alfie is super, super, super sensitive and a way like that is just going to get him to be against you. To get him to trust me and to jump as good as he does and to do so many clear rounds as he does have taken a lot of trust exercises. What is important is that before you try something new that you think your horse is going to be afraid of, that the horse is not too fresh. So in the beginning, before I rode him and before we were going to do things that he was afraid of, I would lunge him first so that he was a little bit tired before we started, because then he didn't have so much energy bottled up that he could use again me and was more relaxed because he had gotten out the worst edge and was more in the mood to be cooperative, to listen to me and to try to do what I want because he was relaxed in his body. Some of the trust exercises we have done together is that he has been attached to a lunge line and we have walked over plastic waters and real waters and stuff like that, and he have been rewarded from following me, and I have given him carrots, and when that has been good, I have also ridden over it. So now he's really, really brave with that. But I also take his temperament into consideration every time I ride. Like when he's tense like this, I wouldn't want to put him through something that is going to scare him and that is going to take away the trust between us. I all the time have to build up the trust so that our circle of trust and the things that he wants to do for me gets bigger and bigger all the time, because Alfie is a really, really great athlete and I want him to continue to develop in a positive way. Our trust bank has grown big and I trust him a lot too, and he trusts me, so we can do things like this to ride without a bridle together. But I don't go riding and jumping without a bridle on a day where I see that he has a bad mental day, then I'm careful.
So now I'm getting ready to go out and jump without, and for whatever I'm doing with him, he always use one of these three bridles. So what is in common with them is that all of them are straight with a room for the tongue, because Alfie is a horse that can get very nervous, and with like a bit that is in pieces, he can sometimes put his tongue over the bit and he is very unstable with the contact. And when I jump with him, I prefer to have these kind of halves, the psoas. So when I jump at home, I have one in rubber, but it is sort of the same system as the metal one that I use for dressage. So this one is more as a snaffle. It's actually a gag. I have two reins on. I have the gag rein just in case something happens that he becomes very afraid of something and he wants to run. Then I can stop him easily with the gag rein. But most of the pass when I'm riding him, I'm just holding in the snaffle rein. So in this half pisoa that I use to jump at home, I have only one rein attached and it's down here. So he also has a show bridle, which is almost identical to the one that I ride dressage on. It's in metal, it has a port here, and it is a half pisoa on the side with one rein. So today when he's gonna jump, he's gonna use this bridle. Okay guys, I always start when I put the bridle on, if I'm gonna have the martingale, with putting the reins through the martingale. And then I just simply put it over the neck. Oh, he's really talking to the horses. I hope he's not gonna scream. Alfie, are you talking with your friends?
Yeah.
also with Alfie don't have a lower nose cam because it's not like, I don't want to tie his mouth together. Like if he wants to keep his mouth open, I'm totally okay with that. And I also have this nose band like really, really loose. He has also a little muff on his nose because I want him to keep his attention forward on the jump and not looking too much up and stuff like that. So that also helps him to make around the jump. Yeah, basically that.
Alfie hates flies, and if he gets a little fly just on his nose, he shakes his head in a funny way like he just did. Anyway, when I'm warming up with him, the only thing that I try to do is just to get him to relax and just take his nose down and forward. Because Alfie is a horse that has a lot of tension and a lot of power in himself, so I don't really have to put a lot of pressure on him. I just want him to relax because then he can jump in a more comfortable way. Also, when I start to jump, I don't want to put any pressure on him or excite him in any way. I just want him to feel relaxed, trust my hand so he can use himself in the right way. This is very different from rider to rider. Like the rider who had him before me, he rode him in a Pelham because he was very, very, very spooky then. So it was easier for them to actually get him to go the way they wanted and to get him to jump the jumps. Well, me, I keep him a lot more free. Because that's my way of riding, and I'm not saying that anything is better than the other, but this works really good for me and Alfie. Alfie prefers to get a lot of hand over the jump, so I try to do my best to always accommodate that. You can also see with my upper body that I keep it forward and I don't put my upper body too early up after the jump, because if I get myself back in the saddle too quick, he is so sensitive that he will land too early. So I make sure that my hand is forward the whole time. And this is funny, guys. Here you can see how sensitive he is. On the grid jump, he gets a fly in his nose and does a very, very, very strange, very funny thing. And then he continues to jump normal. So at this stable, I really have to put one of those nose fly masks on him before our next ride. So in this part of the video, I'm going to show you just a whole video from the show. This is a Grand Prix class in San Giovanni, where we were clear and we ended number 5 in the Grand Prix. So you can see that he can also be like the best boy in the world. As a matter of fact, no matter how he behaves, I always think he is the best boy in the world because I really love him. You can also see how I ride him, that I try to sit very still in front of the jump. Here I correct a little bit forward, but I try to be finished totally and be totally still when he is ready for takeoff so that he can concentrate and just like work on the jump on his own. Because Alfie is a very intelligent jumper, so he always wants to do his best. If we have a pole, it's basically if I am too near or if I have too much pressure on, so that we, like that he cannot concentrate or something like that. Because if it's up to him, he always wants to do right and he always wants to do clear. You can really see that he has like a very positive attitude and he really, really always, always tries to do his best for me. We are really best friends.
Brava Eva, molto bene con il netto al primo giro di gara del Grand Prix, 71 secondi e 42 il tempo in più.
So in this part of the vlog, I'm going to go with you guys back to Gran Canaria. Me and my father had like a huge mission that we were going to go to one of these markets and buy some fake Gucci. In a vlog before about our trip to Gran Canaria, I had we had went to like a shopping center called Jumbo Shopping Center and tried to buy some fake Gucci there, but the fake was just so bad, so it didn't really go. Anyway, here are some clips from the hotel, from the beach, yeah. We lived at a really nice, I don't remember if it was 4-star or 5-star hotel, but they had like all-inclusive. It was my first time on an all-inclusive hotel, but the quality of the food was so freaking good. However, that did not stop me and my daddy to go back to McDonald's and other places where he had taken me to eat when we went on holidays together when I was a kid.
It's not so?
No.
No. What kind?
Fox tail.
I'm just out looking to see if there are some camels that have flown over the Sahara Desert here somewhere.
Now me and my daddy are going to go out and try to find some indoor activities since that Kalima sandstorm is here. So basically everything outside is red and orange because of all the sand, but now we're going to try to find something fun, right puppy?
Yes sir.
Outfit check, yay! Thank you so much, Papa! It's seriously crazy to think about that now all the beaches and the stuff are closed. When I see the clips from our holiday, I really just want to give my daddy a big hug and that we can go back and take another week too. We had such a good holiday together and ate a lot of pizza. You're up next, Daddy! Second pizza of the day! Cool! Daddy cool! Pizza time! Yeah, puppy! Hey guys, I'm going to try the biggest soda ever. I've never seen a soda like that before, so I'm excited to try it. A follower saw this picture of me and my father from the holiday and sent me a DM and said that he needed to get his mole, the big black one, there removed. So when he came back from the holiday, he got it removed and the doctor, like in Narvik, in Norway, where he lives, he said it was really good that he came. So thank you so much, guys, for helping out. But guys, we did complete our mission and we got to buy some fake Gucci on Gran Canaria. Let me show you.
So I told you that when me and my dad was in Gran Canaria, we were trying to find some fake Gucci because I wanted to buy fake Gucci and do one of those videos like where you have fake Gucci and you go to the actual Gucci store. So like the first day we were there, we were at like this shopping center called Jumbo and they had like a lot of fake there. But the problem was that the fake was just so bad that you wouldn't even believe that it was fake. You know that somebody was actually trying to have like real Gucci. Then we went to a market. And I can't say it was easy to find good fake there either, or fake that was like even an existing model, because these people that had been making fake had like come up with their own model and like designed some stuff themselves and just put a Chanel logo or a Gucci logo on. So I was like, oh my god. Anyway, I managed to find this hoodie. I mean, you can see that it's fake. It's not really how the Gucci ever makes this logo, but I'm gonna like try to use it. This one I think I paid 20 euros for. And then I found this bag. This is actually a model that has existed. It's an old model. So this model has existed, which is a plus. The logo is like a little bit rusty, but what is a plus is that it has existed. So people there at the Gucci store is gonna see that it's a fake, but at least that it is an existing model. I wonder what they're gonna say when I come with this one. But I mean, look here, it's like rusty everywhere. For this, I paid 25 euros, which I actually think is a lot. I think if you are like me, that you love bags and stuff, and you don't want to spend money for a real one, I think to buy a fake one is like a bad idea, because first of all, look at that. And second of all, because I mean, out of respect for the designer that has put a lot of work and effort into it and the people that have sewn it and tried to be really specific with the details. So then I would rather like buy, for example, a Guess bag or the cheap line of Valentino, because there is like some bags that called Valentino that are for a really reasonable price. Not like the Valentino that costs like 6,000 euros, but another one. And for example, Armani has some cheaper bags that are really nice. I would actually like recommend that. Anyway, it's gonna be exciting to see the reaction when all of this
virus is
finished and I can go with this to the real Gucci store. So that's gonna be a video for the future.
Now over to the Valentine's Day haul.
Okay, so this is the white Dior set that I got from Valentine's Day. I think it's really beautiful. And yeah, what can I say? I mean, I'm looking forward to wearing it in the summer. And I think it's cute like this. It would also be cute with a skirt over this one. And yeah, this is the black Dior set that I got. It's exactly 100% same as the other one, but to have some more variation, I got it altered to a crossbody instead. So I think it looks good. I'm actually really happy about it, looking forward to wear it. I also got this skirt from Versace, and I think it looks really good together with the Dior top. And also this cropped t-shirt from Versace that Francois picked out to wear together with the skirt. Like, I think it's a really nice set actually, very summery, very cute. I also got this Fendi dress that was really long when I got it, but we have altered it, so it's shorter now, and I honestly love it. Very casual, very cute. It's like Norwegian colors and Fendi, so it's a big thumbs up. Now over to what I bought in Gran Canaria. I bought a little necklace like this. It says, oh my god, it says Eva on it, and I bought a similar saying Helle for my best friend. Then it was so cold there, so I bought these Levi's jeans, and also a Calvin Klein jacket that you have seen me wearing a lot in the stable lately, and this Tommy Hilfiger sweatshirt. Or sweater, it's not a sweatshirt, it's a sweater, it's like knitted. And also this glittery top, I don't know what brand it is, but I love it. I think it's gonna look really cute with the navy Pro Horse jeans in the summer. No, not jeans, navy Pro Horse tights.
Guys, if you want more videos like this, remember to subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and suggest other ideas in the comments down below. Thanks, guys!